Hey guys, what's happening? My name's Cal, and in today's Swift and Xcode tutorial, we're going to be having a look at user defaults and creating a pretty simple settings page for your iOS application. User defaults are a really great way to store a small amount of data that's persistent, rather than using core data and creating a whole entity and a whole bunch of stuff. If you just have like one or two little things you need to save, like settings, for example, like a dark theme or a light theme, then user defaults is a great place to store them. But yeah, let's get started. Creating a new Swift and Xcode project. This is an iOS app that we're building. I'm just going to call it Settings User Defaults. We're going to use Storyboard and our programming language is Swift. Then first thing we're going to do is just get our layout sorted. So I'm heading into the main storyboard. I'm going to drag in a label. I'm going to center this horizontally in the container, as well as giving it a little bit of space to the top. We're going to make the text size a little bigger, so up to 26. And we're just going to call this Settings, so a bit of a title. Then I'm going to drag in a horizontal stack view. And then I'm just going to set that below our settings label. And then I'm just going to copy and paste down our settings label, as well as adding in a switch. So we're just going to have a basic on off switch. And then we're just going to put our settings label inside that stack view so that you can see now that they're both nested inside that horizontal stack view. Modifying those constraints, as well as changing the label to be off initially. And then I'm going to copy and paste down our settings label once again, putting this just below our switch. I'm going to change the text to theme. And then I'm going to add in a little bit of space on our label, so just changing the width to 100. Next, what we're going to do is add in a segment. So this is going to be for a theme, so we're just going to give it a little bit of vertical spacing as well and center it horizontally. Next, I'm going to add one more segment to our segmented control. I'm going to call the first one light theme, and the next one's going to be a dark theme, and then finally a red theme. It doesn't really matter what the themes are. I just wanted to make sure that there was three options that you could choose from. Cool, so that's all looking pretty good. What we're going to do now is open up the assistant editor and create some outlets. So I'm just going to drag from the switch, I'm calling it on-off switch, as well as calling the label an on-off label. And then I'm going to create an outlet for the segment, just calling it theme segment. And then we're going to create an action for both the segment as well as the switch. So just calling the first one segment changed and the next one switch changed. Now we can close off the assistant editor. We're going to head back into our view controller. And firstly, we're just going to declare our user defaults. So I'm just going to say let user defaults equal to user defaults and standard. Next, inside our switch changed function, I'm going to say if our on-off switch is on, we want to save to our settings, so save to our user defaults, that the switch is on, so therefore it's now turning off. So I'm going to set user defaults, set it to true. And then for key, we're going to create a string at the top. We're going to call it let on-off key, and just giving it a name of on-off key. It doesn't really matter what the key is named. Just want to make sure that you use it in a variable like this, so that when you reference it later, you can't really make mistakes rather than just copy and pasting down the string. If you declare it as a sort of static variable at the top, and that way the compiler can help you out with minor typos and that sort of thing. You know you're using the right key for the right thing. As well, we're going to set our switch text to off or on, depending on whether or not the switch is turning off or on. And then we just need to go into our viewDidLoad, and we're going to create a function. We're going to call it checkSwitchState. When the view loads, we need to see whether or not the switch needs to be toggled to on or off. And we're just going to say if userDefaults.bool, so get a boolean, for our key, our on-off key, if it's true, we want to set our on-off switch to true and animated to be false. And we also want to set our label text to be on. And then we just want to do the opposite if our boolean returns false. So let's build and run this now and see if when we set our switch to on or off and then we close the app and then we reopen it, that the state that the switch was in previously is still there. We've successfully saved it to the user defaults and then we've set our switch accordingly based on the settings. Cool, so next let's get our segment working. So I'm going to declare a couple more strings. I'm going to call this next string, I'm going to call it theme key. What's actually inside the string doesn't actually matter. It just needs to be consistent. You need to be using the same key. So I'm going to create a dark theme, a light theme, as well as our red theme. Next, we're going to create a function calling it update theme. Inside here, we're going to say let theme equal to user defaults string for our theme key. And then if our theme is equal to our light theme, we just want to set our selected segment index to 0, as well as setting our background color to white. We're going to copy that and paste it down two more times and changing those to else if statements. And we're going to say if our theme is equal to our dark theme, selected segment is equal to 1. And for red, we're going to set it to 2, as well as just changing the background colors that they set. Next, inside our segment change method, we're going to create a switch. We're just going to call our segment, get its selected segment index. And then in the case of it being 0, we're going to set our user defaults to our light theme for our key, our theme key. Our default is going to be our light theme. Then we're going to copy and paste down our case 0 and just changing the case to 1 and 2 and dark and red. And then finally, we just need to call our update theme function. Cool, and if we build and run this, you can see that it's working in the same way. You can choose the dark and it changes the background color. And when we close and reopen the app, it's remembered what the settings were, what the user's preferences were, whether or not they wanted to use dark or light theme. And yeah, so there you have it. That's how you use user defaults in Swift and Xcode, a really great way to build a settings page.
I hope you found some use in this tutorial, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.